जय राधा माधव कुंज विहारे जय गोपी जन वल्लभा गिरिवर धारे जय जय गोपी जन वल्लभा गिरिवर धारे यशोदनंदन व्रज जन रंजन यशोदनंदन व्रज जन रंजन यमुना तीरावन चारे यमुना तीरावन चारे जय राधा माधव कुंज विहारे जय गोपी जन वल्लभा गिरिवर धारे यशोदनंदन व्रज जन रंजन यशोदनंदन व्रज जन रंजन यमुना तीरावन चारे यमुना तीरावन चारे जय राधा राज हरे राधा राज हरे राधे जय सीताराम लक्ष्मण भक्त हनुमान सीताराम लक्ष्मण भक्त हनुमान जय गौरनिताय जय गौरनिताय जय 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 प्रभुपा 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 जय 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 गुरुदेव 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 जय जय
जय विष्णुपाद परमहंस परिव्राजकाचार्य अष्टोत्तर एसी भक्ति स्वामी श्रील प्रभुपाद की गौर प्रेमानंदे ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरये नष्टप्रायेषु अभद्रेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवया भगवते उत्तमश्लोके भक्तिर्भवति नैष्ठिकी Today on this auspicious day of Ekadashi, we have a practice of reading from Srila Prabhupada Lilamrita, which is most auspicious. as is clearly mentioned in the Ekadashi Kirtan by our Acharya Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, that Shuddha Bhakta Charana Renu Bhajana Anukula Bhakata Seva Paramasiddhi Premalatikhara Mula. So, as it is mentioned in the Bhagavad Gita as well, that there are two living entities, Kshara Purusha and Akshara Purusha. The Kshara Purusha are the people who are conditioned in this world, and the Akshara Purusha are eternally liberated. And why this information is required for us? Because we are in touch with all conditioned people around us. And of course, there are some liberated souls also, but we don't know how to identify them. So when you can't even understand, identify the liberated souls, so where is the question of understanding the personality who is beyond this conditioned and liberated souls? This is the fundamental point. So that's why somehow we should be coming in touch with liberated soul, that is Akshara Purusha. When we understand this Akshara Purusha, there is a possibility, there is a hope that we will be able to understand the personality who is beyond these two conditioned and liberated souls. That's why the process of hearing about the liberated soul or eternal liberated soul, the Acharyas or Srila Prabhupada, is put into our practice. It is by design. By default, we will not do anything. Because generally we are connected to Krishna. We are connected to Krishna. But we are never connected to the Acharyas, or I mean to say devotees. But unless we are connected to devotees, especially Acharya, by hearing, then there is a possibility of developing some desire or some attachment to a Supreme Personality of Godhead. That's why on this Ekadashi day, it is a practice in all ISKCON centers to hear the Srila Prabhupada Leelamrita, so that we are coming in touch with Akshara Purusha. Without coming in touch with Akshara Purusha, take it for granted, we'll never understand the Supreme Personality of Godhead who is beyond these two Purushas. By default, we'll never read Prabhupada Leelamrita. If I ask you a question, maybe embarrassing to many one of you, how many of you have read Leelamrita? It's not an embarrassing one, I can ask you. Who has not read the Leelamrita? Very embarrassing question. So by default, we'll never do. By default, we'll never read Srila Prabhupada Leelamrita. So there's an opportunity for us to really read Srila Prabhupada's, understand, and then get into the realm of pure devotional service or understanding. So I'll start from reading Leelamrita, going on. Prabhupada conducted an intensive three-day lecture campaign in Mexico City, speaking at National University of Mexico, the Masonic Lodge, and the Theosophical Society, and appearing on television show with some 30 million viewers. He also held initiations at the temple on two consecutive days. Mexico was similar to India, he said, with pious people and tropical climate. Even when he walked early in the morning in the park, many people followed him back to the temple. They recognized him as a saint and wanted his benediction. This is the beauty of the Akshara Purushas. They automatically attract the conditioned soul. If a person is attracting, how to really identify Akshara Purusha, the liberated soul, that simply by his presence, if he is attracting millions of people, then he is liberated people. Okay, somebody may ask, oh, we see that many Mayavadi lectures also, though thousands of people attend. Does it mean that they are Akshara Purusha? There's a difference. The difference is that not that we get attracted at that moment, but we get attracted forever. If somebody influences us to get attracted to him permanently and making us to get to pledge that yes, I am connected life after life, then we can understand that he is an eternally liberated person. Otherwise we get attracted, even people get attracted to some sinisters, but the moment he goes out, they will forget. Or some Mayavadic lecture he may give, speaker he may give, people may dance and do something, but the moment they go home, they don't know what to do, so over a period they forget. But the eternally liberated person association is that he will get, by his influence, we get connected to Krishna, because he is having a close proximity to the Supreme Personality of Godhead, who is beyond the conditioned soul and liberated soul. So here Srila Prabhupada went to Mexico City, and a 3-day lecture campaign continuously was speaking at the University of Mexico and the Theosophical Society, and is also appearing on the television show. He was giving so many television talks also, where millions of people are looking at. And you know, very wonderful, Srila Prabhupada's a very simple way of challenging that I am not this body, I am there in this body. When I leave this body, I'll go into other body. So what is difficult in understanding this? Simple. It appears so simple, but this is a challenge. The whole story starts from there. So even if you look at that, that's why Srila Prabhupada very clearly mentions in Bhagavad Gita, the story of, we always think that story ends with Bhagavad Darshan. But if you look at the Acharyas or the stories in Bhagavatam, story starts from Bhagavad Darshan. Within 6 months, the Dhruva Maharaj got the darshan of Krishna. So as per our knowledge, our understanding, his story should have ended because he got the Bhagavad Darshan. But Krishna said, no, the story starts now. You please rule for next 36,000 years. The story starts from there. That's what Prabhupada is mentioning. Why don't you understand that you are not his body? What is the difficulty? Because the story starts after understanding this basic point. Brahma bhuta prasannatma na sochati na kankshati samasarveshu bhuteshu mad bhaktim labate param. My devotion is starting after understanding that I am not this body. How do you understand that? I understood what the meaning of that. That Prabhupada has demonstrated everywhere. He has spoken to the students at the National University of Mexico, and he has done to the Theosophical Society, and also he has appeared on the television. When you are speaking on the television, you don't know who is going to watch. But students require different philosophy. Theosophical people require different philosophy. Whereas when you talk on the television, it goes to millions of people. Who is going to see? Which religion is going to see? No. But for every religion, there is only one principle, that you are not the body, first principle. Why Prabhupada is constantly, vehemently, repeatedly saying that, understand this point, because after that only Krishna's devotion is starting. If we don't understand that, Krishna's devotion is far from us. Mad bhaktim labhate param. Till the God should appear either in our heart, in front of our eyes, and even if he appears in front of eyes, he has given same instruction to Dhruva Maharaj, please rule for 36,000 years. When he appeared to Prahlad Maharaj, he said, again rule for thousands of years. When he appeared to Prithu Maharaj, please rule for. The God, when appears, he will instruct. When he appears in our heart, he will also say that, please work. We will be able to work only when the God appears in our heart. That is we understood the Bhagavad Darshan. And how do you understand that we really imbibe the philosophy of we are not the body? For that Krishna is telling through Prabhupada purports that Brahma Bhuta Prasanna Atma Na Sochati Na Kankshati Sama Sarveshu Bhuteshu. So the moment you are equal, no enmity, equanimity with all caste, creed, devotees, everything, that you are not in the body. This is the exact principle Srila Prabhupada has put as the third purpose of ISKCON. Third purpose of ISKCON really, very clearly says that you go to Krishna, Srila Prabhupada is not mentioning. First you get attracted to each other. First you become attracted to each other and connectedly you go to Krishna. That is third purpose of ISKCON. ISKCON means we are having really divine brotherhood. That is third purpose of ISKCON. The moment you are showing some difference with different categories, then you are in the bodily platform. You are actually abusing the third purpose of ISKCON. And ISKCON is the body of Srila Prabhupada. And whatever he has mentioned, he has put everything in the seven purposes. If we ask anybody, any ISKCON devotee, what are the four regulative principles? Even a child would tell. What are the 10 offenses not to be committed? Here and there we'll try to tell. If I ask anybody, what are the 7 purposes of ISKCON? How many will be able to tell? Please lift hand who knows 7 purposes of ISKCON. I'm asking my question. Who knows the 7 purposes of ISKCON? You will ask me, what is that? So if we are not understood 7 purposes of ISKCON, we are not understood the Prabhupada mode. Very simple. The first purpose is to systematically propagate the spiritual knowledge to society at large and to educate people in spiritual practices in order to check the imbalance in the values of life to achieve real unity and peace in the world. Is the first purpose of ISKCON, which is aimed at universal brotherhood. And he's saying that it has to be preached to society at large. That is theory. And he's also mentioning in the second part, he has given 2 activities: to systematically propagate the spiritual knowledge to society at large, theory, and to educate them in spiritual practices, practice. Both theory and practice, Prabhupada has emphasized. For what? To check the imbalances in the values of life. There is so much imbalance in the values in this human society around us, but if Srila Prabhupada has envisioned through his purposes, theory and practical, and that will remove the imbalances. And that's what Srila Prabhupada is, wherever he went, he's preaching the same thing. And the beginning of the story is that you are not the body. The point. And what it will finally result? It will result in 2. One is real unity and the peace in the world. And for that, the third purpose Krishna Srila Prabhupada has mentioned, that all the members of the society, he made very clear in third purpose, he did not, if you look at the first purpose, in society at large, he has used the small letter S. But when he has put the third purpose of ISKCON, the members of society, he has used the capital letter. Shows that he is talking about ISKCON, that is International Society for Krishna Consciousness. He wants for that first people should come together and then go together to Krishna. Not that Chakravarti Prabhu will go to Krishna separately, Vaishnavangri Prabhu is going separately to Krishna. No! Chakravarti Prabhu and Vaishnavangri Prabhu will put hand in hand and then go. Not they too. They will extend their hands, more people, so much, and they will go to Krishna. That is the third purpose of ISKCON. That is possible only when this Brahma Bhuta Prasannatma Na Sochati Na Kankshati Samasarveshu Bhuteshu Mad Bhakti Labhariparam. Then only the real devotion starts, when we really come out of this platform of the body. That's the Prabhupada saying, what is the difficulty? What is the difficulty? The difficulty is here itself. But we understand this point, then we'll really go in. I request all the hearers here that please put the seven purposes of ISKCON framed and put it home. You have put tens and tens of dozens of Krishna's photos. Please put the nicely get it framed, seven purposes of ISKCON, and put it. That will give guidance. That will give guidance to us. Otherwise, we will not be fulfilling the real mission of Srila Prabhupada. We may be doing, the Krishna consciousness is so wonderful that whatever you do is correct, whatever you say is correct, it may not be absolute. But we are in the frame of the seven purposes. I am sure that we are absolutely in the frame of Krishna consciousness, Srila Prabhupada, what he has envisioned. And Srila Prabhupada, when he went to Mexico, he liked that area very, it is very tropical, sweating so much, like this. So he liked that very much, and the morning walks, he went, and he was very happy. And many people even just followed automatically. That is, by default or by design, they get attracted. That is beauty of the eternally liberated souls. And he also done the spiritual initiations for two consecutive days. That is connect. That is connect. We have to really get connected to the parampara. We should get really connected parampara. This is most important. And Srila Prabhupada repeatedly and wherever he has done, we always say that, I am not eligible. But Prabhupada said that eligibility is there or not, I am going to decide. So he has just, irrespective of their caste, creed or eligibility, he simply connected everybody to Krishna consciousness. And there's a one nice devotee, he is trying to recollect. That is Chisukananda. On Sunday afternoon, there were more than 500 people in the temple room. And after lecture, Srila Prabhupada went back to his room alone. And there was a big kirtan with 500 to 600 people chanting, Jai Prabhupada, Jai Prabhupada, Jai Prabhupada, Jai Prabhupada. Jai Prabhupada, Jai Prabhupada, Prabhupada. Jai Prabhupada, Jai Srila Prabhupada. Jai Prabhupada, Jaya Prabhupada, Prabhupada. Jai Prabhupada, Jaya Srila Prabhupada. Jai Prabhupada, Jaya Prabhupada, Prabhupada. Jai Prabhupada, Jaya Srila Prabhupada. Jaya Prabhupada, Prabhupada, Jaya Prabhupada, Jaya Srila Prabhupada. So, the 50 years back story is just repeated here in the Mexico temple. When Prabhupada went back to his room, everybody chanting, 500, 600 people, same, Jai Prabhupada, Jai Prabhupada, Jai Prabhupada. They became very, very ecstatic. It seemed like the temple walls were going to come down. That was the mood when Prabhupada was there. When everybody was chanting, Jai Prabhupada, Jai Prabhupada, the Chisukananda is recollecting, my God, it appears that as if the walls are going to come down. It's the same thing happened, just like that when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was traveling to Vrindavan, he wanted to go through the Nadia, and wherever he went, the Yajman has hosted Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, lost all his compound walls. That is the blessings he got. So, because so many hundreds and thousands are coming, their walls could not really stop them. That was the mood of Srila Prabhupada. How that mood is coming? This mood will come when you get engaged in the real service of Prabhupada. This mood will come. Prabhupada is not relaxed. There's a difference between we becoming enthusiastic and somebody is enthusiastically pushing us. The big difference. We always read उपदेश अमृत दैट देयर आर सिक्स थिंग्स रिक्वायर्ड फॉर आवर भक्ति टू गो अप उत्साह एवरीबडी विल टेल नो प्रॉब्लम इफ दे सिट हियर दे विल गिव वन आवर लेक्चर नो प्रॉब्लम बट व्हाट इज उत्साह व्हाट इज एंथुजियाज्म हाउ डू आई नो दैट इट इज देयर विथ मी आर नॉट हु इज एक्चुअली पुशिंग दैट एंथुजियाज्म इन मी हाउ डू यू अंडरस्टैंड इज देयर एन एग्जाम्पल दैट आई कुड से फ्रॉम टेक फ्रॉम दैट we can see from Prabhupada Lilamrita how he has imbibed injected the enthusiasm what is the symptom of enthusiasm the symptom of enthusiasm is I always take initiative the fact that for example if a child is want to get up is just planning so there is no rule book how a child should get up he should hold the wall either he can hold the table or he should hold mother's lap there is no rule book mentioned how to get up but the child will think how do I get up she will find various means he will take out initiatives to get up that is called enthusiasm if the Guru Maharaj is telling my dear spiritual son do this I am getting lot of troubles Maharaj no problem do this after 3 months Maharaj came what happened no Maharaj I am getting this problem okay do this he has giving lot of thing after 3 years what happened I have given so far 50 ideas still Maharaj some problem is coming so now you tell me whether the disciple now by then Maharaj has given 50 ideas so whether Maharaj is enthusiastic or disciple is enthusiastic answer I am asking answer this is yam that Maharaj this is disciple should I leave this or this I think you are little hesitating speak who is enthusiastic in this case guru or shishya guru so in your heart if the initiatives are not coming take for granted you are not enthusiastic finish even the enthusiasm is not there nischaya is no more there after that what to talk about dhairya is completely absent everything is lost but here Srila Prabhupada has imbibed his enthusiasm how he is pushed when Chaitanya Charitamritam to be printed 19 volumes The BBT said that oh okay no problem we'll be able to print one book in a month earlier it was taking 3 months a book to print now that we have our own press we can print one book in a month Prabhupada do you think that he is oh good very good haribo no stop nonsense I want all the 19 volume to printed in 2 months this is the pinnacle of enthusiasm आप क्या करेगा मुझे मालूम नहीं मुझे ये अचीव करना है यू मे से दैट ओ बट आई डोंट नो प्रभुपाद इज नॉट देयर सो हु विल डू रीड प्रभुपाद लीलामृता विद दिस मोड वेयर डू आई गेट दिस इंस्पिरेशन इन द एंथुजियाज्म लुक इनटू दैट देन यू विल गेट एंड चेक योरसेल्फ हाउ मेनी इनिशिएटिव्स यू हैव टेकन ऑन मंथली बेसिस ओके टुडे इज अगस्त हाउ मेनी इनिशिएटिव्स आई हैव टेकन put a chart if your number is coming down better get into some other activity because there's no initiative if your graph is going up initiatives one by one by one my god fantastic why the acharyas mentioned utsaha nischaya dhairya what is the sequence what is the purpose of that when you have initiatives when you get committed to that but there will be so many problems will come your dhoti pulling people will be there shikha pulling people will be there your dhoti kurta pulling people will be there at home office wherever it is but the third property that dhairya will come into picture determination will come into picture but I don't have initiative at all so where is the question of dhairya coming into picture everything is absent But in Prabhupada's presence, everybody got enthused. Prabhupada did not tell, "Go and chant my name." but just simply his presence. This simple presence made everybody to chant as if that walls are going to come down. How this enthusiasm will come back to our heart? How it will come? Did we ever think? We always say that I want to go to back to Godhead. Why? Here it is full of miseries. It's full of miseries. I want to go to back to Godhead. So you are not interested in Krishna to serve because you want to get rid of your problems. It is pakka Mayavadi approach. Mayavadi says that here it is Brahma Satyam Jagan Mithya. So let me get, now I am realized as God. So there cannot be two gods. So one God is there, I'll go and mix. But if we understand that the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's message that I am long, for long time I'm away from my home. Long time I'm away from home. That's why I want to go back. Yugaitam nimeshena chakshusha pravrishaitam shunyaitam jagat sarvam govinda virahename. In this mode, we are eligible to say, I want to go to back to Godhead. If it is because I am suffering here with so many people around, that is not Prabhupada mentioned. You will get this realization only when we really serve with all enthusiasm the Srila Prabhupada movement. We can see various instances. The moment Srila Prabhupada, after initiation, he went back to his room, hundreds of people are chanting and dancing. And here this Chitsukananda Prabhu is saying, they became very, very ecstatic, and as it seemed like the temple walls are going to come down. I was in Srila Prabhupada's room and he said, what is this kirtan? They are making so much noise. So it has reached to the room of Srila Prabhupada. So much chanting, everybody doing that. I said, they are chanting your name. And I went down to see what was going on. And all of the people are waiting to come into Srila Prabhupada's room. It was like that they wanted to charge up to Srila Prabhupada's room to be able to see him. They kept yelling his name, Prabhupada, Prabhupada. Just like the repetition of history. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was in his room, everybody was shouting, we want to come inside and see Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Same history was repeating. But the same thing should appear again and again. Only when really we imbibe the mood of Srila Prabhupada, what he has injected into his disciples. Look into any book of Srila Prabhupada. Backside you will find 40 to 50 or 60 pages are just dedicated to the subject index, sloka index, word index, this and that. You look into Indian version of that, all 60 pages will vanish. We are no more enthusiastic. We just translate books and give them. But at that time, Prabhupada movement, Prabhupada was there, everybody was so enthusiastic. Let me give you the best. You will be surprised to see Chaitanya Charitamritam. They were drawing, because since 2 months time was only given, everybody was drawing. Drawing on the canvas, and they slept on the canvas itself. And by time he woke up, the canvas is not there. It was next to his place. The canvas was finished. Somebody else came and finished that drawing. That was mode. They took only one time meal. Not fixed. That's mode of that. When do we imbibe that back? That enthusiasm in our heart. That is need of the hour. That's need of the hour. And that will come. That will come only by Leelamrita. That will, because we are not such a pure souls to get inspiration from Bhagavatam. We immediately, that was Dhura Maharaj in such a yuga, he might have done. Very good to hear. But it's not possible. To my dear brother, for your comment, I have so many people, our senior Vaishnavas, they have performed. Not in such a yuga, just this yuga. Look into this, read this, meditate upon this, and swallow this. then enthusiasm will come. Till enthusiasm doesn't come, we'll be lost. We'll be lost means we may not be lost. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, Anandambudhi Vardhanam. There's an ocean. Ocean, if somebody wants to grow continuously, nobody would like, because all the sea phase buildings will get merged. So nobody likes that. But there is an Anandambudhi which constantly grows. But is that our experience? The first day of ISKCON, we were jumping and dancing, our whole shirt was sweat. First time in my life, I have taken bath with my sweat. First day of ISKCON presence. Now, that was the peak of enthusiasm, will touch the sky. As the months pass, days pass, it was supposed to go up to the sky, but that graph will slowly tapering down. Whom to blame? We blame so many people around us except me. That I lost my enthusiasm. That is the reason. So when you keep Srila Prabhupada's and Acharya in front of us and constantly take inspiration from that, we will be lost. Try to understand that. That's why on Ekadashi day, hearing Srila Prabhupada Lilamrita is the most important. It is, I would say that, can anybody survive without breathing? Breathing is an optional or compulsory? Tell me my answer. Is it optional? Somebody is not answering. Is it optional or compulsory, breathing? Compulsory. Similarly, reading Prabhupada Lilamrita is no optional. It is compulsory. It is for your spiritual survival. Enthusiasm. If you lose enthusiasm, you are the loser. You means we. I am including myself. That's why I always, by fortunately, I got the opportunity. For last 20 years, I am spending at least 4 to 5 hours every day with Prabhupada books. Lilamrita, already I have translated in our Back to God magazine, and I am taking up this. My sincere request to all of you on this Ekadashi day, that please take this Prabhupada Lilamrita to your heart to keep your enthusiasm intact. Nobody is going to enthuse you. Please mind that. Your ever well-wisher is who? Only Srila Prabhupada. Please remember this. He is only your well-wisher. He can only inject the inspiration, enthusiasm in you. Nobody else. So for that, you should be in touch with that. So, Chisukananda, he came down and everybody came to Srila Prabhupada's room and everybody shouting, Prabhupada, Prabhupada, Prabhupada. And so I came to Prabhupada. Then Chisukananda Prabhu went inside and told, Prabhupada, they want to see you. Then Srila Prabhupada said, well, let them come. You will find that so many times, there are so many people outside. So the doorkeeper thinks that, Maharaj should not be disturbed. So he would stop everybody. They will be shouting. So ultimately he will go. But he doesn't know who is inside. Inside is a big ocean is there. Inside the big ocean, that is ocean of mercy is inside. The ocean may be contained in a room, but it is not a room because it is the heart. Room may be containing small walls, but the person who is inside, like Prabhupada, for his heart, there are no room, there is no walls, there are no doors. Any number can go inside. So Prabhupada said, please let them come inside. That is the manifestation of ocean of mercy. Please try to understand. We'll understand from each and every sign or activity or his gesture. Understand, there is an ocean of mercy. Such ocean of mercy only can deliver us. Thus, such type of ocean of mercy only can enthuse us. Such ocean of mercy only can inject enthusiasm in us so that we can continue in our spiritual path. And what is the purpose of that? Please mind that the moment you think that I want to get delivered, you are not understood the mood of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu or the Guru Parampara. The moment you understand that I want to preach. Even Bhaktivinoda Thakur says, "Kabe hove bol, o din amar." He was saying that when the day will come, that I'll become most humble, and I'll develop mercy towards all living entity. Real preaching will happen only when we develop mercy towards all living entities. Otherwise, the preaching is going to increase your crown weight. Your crown weight is going to increase. But if you have a mercy to a living entity, your heart will increase. Your crown will not increase. There is going to be a big difference. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur is saying that when I will develop the mercy towards all living entities, I will relinquish all my comforts and I will set ahead to preach Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mission. This is the day we should be aspiring. Then we know that, yes, we are in the real mood of Srila Prabhupada. As Srila Prabhupada also has won the heart of his spiritual master simply by single word, that you came here to this world to completely smash the impersonalism. So by simple word, he has really conquered the heart of the spiritual master. Similarly, the moment we say that we are here to preach the Krishna conscious movement in the nook and corner, and we become resolute, then we will be pleasing Prabhupada. Prabhupada is everywhere. He is there in his books, he is there in temples, he is in our hearts, he is in our home. I don't know if he is in our heart or not. He is at our home, that is guaranteed. Now the Prabhupada has to enter from his altar at home to our heart. Then he is going to enthuse. Krishna should enter into our heart. The moment the Prabhupada enters, Guru enters our heart, then Krishna will enter into our heart. Then the enthusiasm, for our enthusiasm, there won't be any bounds. So, the Chitsukananda Prabhu is further saying, so I immediately arranged people to come in, and he had two doors in his room, and they were coming through one door and left, and from the left side, and leaving the door from the right. One by one in line, they just filtered through like a great parade, coming and offering different words to Srila Prabhupada. Most of people were saying in Spanish, "Your divine grace, your holiness, please bless me, give me your benediction." So we had to really pray to Prabhupada. You see, Spanish people are really praying, "My divine grace, please bless me, please give your blessing, benediction," praying. How many times we pray to Prabhupada, the Guru, that please bless me so that I will imbibe the mood of the Acharya Parampara. When the child is asking, the mother surely gives. But how many times we are asking, we should be asking. As everybody, a Spanish person, first time he has seen, coming in the queue, is asking, "My dear divine grace, please bless me, give me benediction." That is, and when that comes, really the benediction comes, and everyone was praying for his benediction, and as people would come in, they would bow down, everyone extremely submissive, and there were many people with tears in their eyes to see the great saint Srila Prabhupada, and they said, "Srila Prabhupada, please give me your blessings." Everybody was trying to cry. Just imagine, my God, we can't imagine that condition, but that situation was there. And the same scene can come again and again, only for next 10,000 years after that. So at least plan for within 10,000 years. No? You want to go immediately. Prabhupada is planning for 10,000 years to preach, and everybody wants to go back immediately. So who is going to preach? I don't know. If you are real mood of pleasing Prabhupada, say that. I have seen my Guru Maharaj was writing his Vyas Puja offering to Srila Prabhupada this year, and writing, "Srila Prabhupada, I am begging to you that I will get to serve ISKCON movement life after life." With that sentence he has completed. That is mood of all the submissive, real devotees, followers of Srila Prabhupada. Try to understand this. The moment I want to go, means you are no more dear to Krishna. He will decide you are required to come or not. He will decide. Our decision is only to serve, only aspire to serve, only aspire to get blessing. Maharaj, mujhe aashirwad de do, haath khinch ke aisa mat lagao, kuch fayda nahi. Absolutely no need. Just work in such a way that for fraction of second you will enter, he will enter into our heart. When Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur was recommended, oh, this Abhay Babu is a very, very sincere devotee. He serves so much our temple, so he wants initiation from you. The temple president has recommended to the temple president. Then Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur mentioned, I know him. He wants to hear. I marked him. There was, he did not, hey Abhay Babu, come on. You are a good boy, you are hearing, so I ticked you. He did not say. It is already there in heart. So, by our actions, by our enthusiasm, we should enter a fraction of second. Even a fraction of second, we enter into the heart of Srila Prabhupada and Acharyas. What is that? Oh, this boy is very enthusiastic. Oh, this mother is very enthusiastic. Finish. 1 second. Life is starts. Real life starts from then. Jitna bhi Maharaj ya Prabhupada ke zoom mein jitna bhi nacho ghumo pasina nikalo kuch nahi hone wale. You have to enter into the heart of the acharyas by your action. The moment we enter into the heart, who is there in the heart of a Vaishnav? Tumhara hrudaye sada Govinda Vishram. So the Govinda is resting in the heart of a pure devotee. The moment you entered in the heart of a pure devotee, by default you are coming closer to Krishna. Then the flow starts to you. Dadami buddhi yogam tam yena mama payantite. By that you will be coming to me. This is the purpose. This is the process of really getting into Krishna consciousness. Getting into Srila Prabhupada. What is the difficulty? You are not the body, you are inside the body. What is the difficulty to understand? Because we are not entered into the Acharya's heart. We have not entered into the heart of the Guru. So how can we understand? That is the problem. This is the difficulty. So Prabhupada has demonstrated, you serve my mission. So all the devotees, disciples serve mission. That's why Prabhupada has entered into it. They are all entered into their heart. That's why they got highly liberated. So same history should be repeated again and again for next 10,000 years. And the best process is to read Prabhupada Leelamrita. This is by design. It is happening in every temple on Ekadashi day. Don't miss that. Don't miss that. Oh, Prabhupada Leelamrita, we know it. You have simply lost opportunity to get rejuvenated. Once in 15 days. If you miss one, once in a month. If you miss two, finish. How many? Your breath is going out. Very dangerous. Very, very precarious. Please, I don't know how many of you have Prabhupada Leelamrita at home. That is the oxygen cylinder. Come, oxygen cylinder ko ghar mein rakho. Jab bhi dam ghut jate, to apne aap laga sakte ho, to bach jayega. Please keep this oxygen cylinder at your home. Leelamrita in all language. One for Yajman, one for Mataji, one for everybody, one book. Not one book. Because agar sabko ek baar dham ghut gaya to kaise agar ek hi oxygen cylinder hai are yahan yajman ko bhi dham ghut gaya aur mata ji ko bhi dham ghut gaya bachchon ko bhi dham ghut gaya oxygen cylinder ek hi hai kaise bachega so jitna ghar mein aadmi hai उतना ऑक्सीजन सिलेंडर रखना है, मतलब प्रभुपाल लीला मुझे रखना है, क्योंकि हिंदी में रखना, गुजराती में रखना, तेलुगु में रखना, किसको कहा है, सो दैट ऑल ऑक्सीजन सिलेंडर्स आर इंटैक्ट, एवरीबॉडी विल बी ब्रीदिंग, एंड सो दैट इज मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर इस्कॉन मूवमेंट, ऑल ऑफ अस शुड बी लिविंग, लिविंग ओनली लिविंग, लिविंग विथ एंथुजियाज्म, लिविंग माइनस एंथुजियाज्म नो वैल्यू, लिविंग लिविंग विथआउट माइनस एंथुजियाज्म नो वैल्यू एब्सोल्यूटली, लिविंग प्लस एंथुजियाज्म इज द रियल डिवोटी लाइफ, रियल प्रभुपाद अनुगा लाइफ, द फॉलोअर ऑफ प्रभुपाद, देन जस्ट इमेजिन वॉट एवर प्रभुपाद हैज एनविजन्ड टू ब्रिंग द रियल यूनिटी एंड पीस इन द वर्ल्ड विल मैनिफेस्ट, इट विल मैनिफेस्ट, बट इफ यू लूज एंथुजियाज्म everything. Mind that Prabhupada already declared for 10,000 years, whether we become enthusiastic or somebody else will be in the coming generation, somebody will become enthusiastic and do it, is up to our choice, up to us. Srila Prabhupada ki, Prabhupada Lila Amritam ki, Gaur Premanande. If you have any questions, most welcome, this humble servant is in front of you. No question means you understood everything, or you are not understood anything, which is correct. आपको सब कुछ समझ में आया, ये सच है, या आपको कुछ भी समझ में नहीं आया, ये सच है, ये भी समझ में नहीं आया, प्रश्न भी समझ, my God, or maybe everybody has gone to trance, everybody has gone to Mexico, huh? Oh, bro, so he is saying that everybody wants oxygen, no. They are very enthusiastic. Baba, kya bol rahe ho? Everybody so enthusiastic, so much tapasya. Koi bhi hila nahi hai, koi bhi soya nahi hai. Iska matlab kya? Enthusiastic. They are all inside devotees. No problem. They are all gone. At this moment, they are not here. They are in Mexico City. They are gone into Prabhupada movement. All glories to Gaura Bhakta Vrinda ki. Thank you very much.